Hi everybody, MJ here. Okay, now I'm going to take you through a couple different ways that you access what's called the Paint Editor in Scratch. The Paint Editor is sort of like a glorified version of Photoshop or some sort of paint tool on your computer that you can open up and adjust anything that is visual. In the case of Scratch, you can edit sprites, you can make new ones, you can edit backdrops, make new backdrops. I'm going to show you a couple different ways that you can access it. Now let's say, for example, here that I have this sprite. Well, you're going to learn about costumes at some point during this, but the way to access the Paint Editor is when you go to Costumes, and it's going to open up this sort of user interface where you have what looks like a drawing board, and you've got your sprite in the center with a number of tools on the sides and a couple of tools on the bottom. Now, a couple of main features. You've got the title up here at the top, so I could name this Sprite Costume 1. And you've got a great undo and redo button. So let's say, for example, that you wanted to go ahead and take away something you had just done. If I were to draw this, but I don't like that anymore, see how this highlighted? Hit it and it's undone what you just did. But if you want to go ahead and redo it, you can just hit redo. Now, Clear is a great tool if you want to go ahead and erase every change that you've made. You can also go ahead and flip things, so flip left, right, or flip up, down. And then last but not least, this button right here basically sets up an X and Y axis so that you can go ahead and set your costume in the center. You can also move it around in case you don't want it directly in the middle of this, but maybe want it a little bit off center. So if I were to put the X and Y axis here, that will then cause the sprite to move accordingly. But if you want to get rid of that, just go ahead and do undo. Okay, great. Now for these on the side, these are really interesting buttons because they allow you to do a variety of things. Let's go ahead and start off at the bottom. This is similar to what you've seen before. Do you remember where you've seen it? That's right. It's similar to this feature up here, duplicate. You can basically do the same thing by clicking whatever it is, and then it'll go ahead and duplicate that particular picture or image that you've gone ahead and clicked on. So I can put this down here, and then all of a sudden, I have two different parts of one sprite. So on the actual arena over here, they'll go ahead and they'll interact together at the same time and go ahead and do the same exact actions. Now this next one right here, this is a paint bucket. Essentially, if you want to color any major shape in your sprite or backdrop, you can go ahead and select down here from the selection of colors. If I want to do a pink cat, I click on pink, and then I go up here and I separately click each major block of color. And then that will go ahead and color the sprite exactly to how I'd like it to be. You also have the option here of making it thicker and smaller. That will come into play when we talk about the pencil feature. You can also get a larger range of colors if you want to go ahead and select for something more specific. And then this feature right here allows you to actually go ahead and pick up a color. So let's say, for example, that you already had something up here and you couldn't remember what color you chose. You could just go ahead and click on it, and then that will go ahead and drop the color down here. So let's go ahead and say, for example, that I'm currently selected on blue, but I want this pink back. All I have to do is go, click, and then it puts that pink back right here in this box. So you know that that's the color that you're currently operating with. Okay. Now, to continue, let's say that you want to go ahead and add text. That's what this button is for. You can click the box, and then you can write whatever you want. And again, you have to select for the color depending on what color font you would like. Then you also have a couple of shapes options. So you could make circular shapes, or you could make more rectangular shapes. And this is great because you can also adjust this accordingly, just like you would on something like Photoshop or even in Microsoft Word. A line tool enables you to actually make very, very straight lines, but if for some reason you don't want to make straight lines and want to do it more freehand, that's what this option is for, pencil. And you'll notice the thickness of the line right now is relatively thick. That's what this part down here was for. If you want to make it thinner, drag this to the left. That makes a thin line. And if you'd like it thicker, drag this to the right. And that makes a much thicker line. Okay. Now this button right here, this is pretty cool because whatever shapes you might have on the paint editor, you can use this tool to adjust the shapes however you want without breaking the shape. So, for example, let's say that I wanted Scratch Cat's eyes to be huge. Click on the eye. Click, drag, and you can adjust that eye however you want, depending on how far or how not far you'd like the shape to go. We could also do the same on the other eye. Okay, and remove, get rid of that. Last but not least, if you ever just want to go back to your regular arrow, you can just click on this, and it'll allow you to move or adjust without being on any of the other features. Now, last but not least, zooming in and zooming out is helpful if you want to go ahead and see the whole thing or specific parts. And you can use these bars on the right and bottom to go ahead and adjust and get an even better view of what you're working with. Pretty basic, very typical, like most computer programs, but still very much a strong part of creating different concepts and creating different shapes within the Scratch community. Now you can do the same thing to backdrops. So let's say that we go back to our scripts area. Down here in the corner, this paint tool will allow you to do the same thing, except that this paint editor looks a little bit different. For the backdrop, you have a couple of different options, but in reality, they're actually very similar to what you had in the costumes area. You still have these buttons up here, and this basic part down here. You have a brush, which allows you to go ahead and make whatever lines you want, similar to what was on the costume area. You have, again, a line function, a rectangle function, a circle function, or ellipse, a text function, a paint bucket function, and you also have this duplicate function down here. Now, in addition, you have an eraser, which allows you to go ahead and erase whatever it is that you have on the screen. And then you also have this tool right here, select. So let's say, for example, that I wanted to select this whole thing, but didn't want to grab each of the small parts individually. I could just make a selection, and that'll grab the whole shape. And then if I want to go ahead and adjust it, I can. Let's say I want to make this a lot smaller. Boom. Now I have another version of the shape, and I can go ahead and do whatever it is that I want with this. I can make it large. I can make it small. I can make it long. I can make it a lot less wide. And I can also go ahead and spiral it around. Boom. And again, with all things, if you want to go ahead and get rid of this, all you have to do is hit your undo button, unless you want to get rid of everything. And that's what the clear is for. This part down here, bitmap and vector, is something that is covered in one of the backdrops videos. If you're curious about that, go ahead and consult it and get all the information that you need. The important thing with the paint editor is that you're as exploratory and as inventive as possible. Because really, with the paint editor, you can create any kind of world or any kind of sprite that you want.